I'm going to show you how we're going to put everything we're going to need into one bowl to make the most crispiest, crunchiest, delicious onion rings. So we're going to start off by putting 1 cup of flour into a bowl. Into that, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of cornstarch. This is the magic right here. With some other things. Okay, to that I'm going to add 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder. Okay, we got some onion powder and some garlic powder. I'm going to put 1 teaspoon of each in here. Cannot have enough onion flavor, can you? As my husband always says, give it a kick. We got 1 teaspoon of cayenne pepper going in. We're going to go 1 more for him today.
There you go.
There we go. Okay, let's go ahead and give this a whisk. You know what I forgot? Salt. I got my 1/2 teaspoon here, but I'm only going to put about 1/2 of that in there. We don't want to oversalt.
Yeah.
That's good enough. We're going to add 1 cup of milk to this. And then we're just going to whisk this together as we're pouring in the milk. This is going to be a thick batter because you want it to hold onto that onion. We're using a cast iron Dutch oven. I've got my husband putting in about 2 inches of oil. Put it on a medium high, 350. Let that start heating up. Take your onion and you want to just cut off your ends. Peel off that outer layer. We're using these white onions here and they're about a medium size. Because I'm going to cut 1-inch rings. So I could get about 5 slices on these onions. And then what you want to do, pop them out. So we're just going to lay these out like that. I'm going to do about 4 onions. I've got my onions all done. Leave yourself a little bit of milk out. That's just to thin your batter out. What you want to do is just take a little bit of your batter, put it in your oil. Now, as you can see, it is sizzling really good in there. And that's what we're looking for. I'm just going to take my rings, place them all into the batter. You can put in as many as you want. Take a fork, just cover them up in the batter. Then I'm just going to pull them out, tap it a little bit, get some of that excess batter off. I'm going to lay it on a plate. That way these all cook at the same time. Okay, so we got some tongs here that he's going to use to place these into the oil.
The oil starts looking like a volcano. You can bring it down a little bit.
Now what we're looking for is a nice golden brown on the bottom sides of these. Once we get to that, we're going to flip them over. Get them nice and brown, like right there. Look at that one right there.
Look how pretty.
What you want to have ready before you even put your onion rings in is a plate with some paper towels on them, because what we're going to do is drain these on the paper towels. And we're going to sprinkle some salt on them. What do you think of my delicious 1 bowl batter onion rings? Mmm. That is so delicious. How to make fried deviled eggs. Take an original classic deviled eggs, ramp it up a level, give it a crunch. I'm going to be using 6 eggs, which will give us 12 fried deviled eggs. I'm going to be using a medium saucepan. I'm going to place my 6 eggs into the bottom of the pan. Fill our pot with water 1 inch above the eggs. Here's a little trick that I've learned. Take some baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon. We're going to sprinkle it in. Place the burner on a high heat. We're going to bring this to a boil. Once the water comes to a boil, we're going to place the lid on the pot. We're going to turn the burner off. We're going to turn the timer on for 11 minutes. Your eggs are done. Create a cold water bath. I've got some ice, some water. So we're going to take them out, place them right in. Cool these down just a little bit, and we're going to go ahead and start peeling them. Crack it, peel off that peel. It's peeling like you wouldn't believe. I just like to run it in the water, dry off any excess water, and then I'm just going to place it on the cutting board. I'm going to bring a bowl over here. Cut your eggs in half lengthwise. Look at the inside of that egg. Perfect. We're going to pop the yolk into the bowl carefully. Just be very careful you don't break the whites. We're gonna set the egg yolks aside. We're gonna make a dredging station. You're gonna need 3 small bowls. In the first bowl, we're gonna add 1/2 cup all-purpose flour, 1/8 teaspoon salt, 1/8 teaspoon garlic powder, paprika, 1/8 teaspoon. We're gonna blend this all together. Crack 2 eggs into our second bowl. Whisk it up really good. third small bowl, we're going to add 1 cup panko crumbs. Take your egg white, place it in the flour, coat it really good, place it into your egg mixture, totally coat it inside and out, shake off the excess, place it into the panko crumb, coat it really good, place it on our plate. Okay, we're gonna fry these up. I'm using a Dutch oven and I'm going to be heating up 40 ounces of Crisco oil. I'm gonna heat this up to a 350 degrees medium high heat. Take my spider or a slotted spoon, place your egg on, drop it in, slide it in. These will take about 2 to 3 minutes to get nice and golden brown on all sides. Oh, look at that. Take them and then place them onto our paper towel covered plate. All right, we're going to put in the second batch. We're going to allow these to drain. Take those egg yolks and we're going to smash them up really good in our bowl. We got to make this taste good. We're going to take some mayonnaise, 1/4 cup into our egg yolks, Dijon stone ground mustard, and add about 2 teaspoons. Garlic powder, tiny little bit. Black pepper, 1/8 teaspoon. Same for the salt, 1/8 teaspoon. Mix this all together, give that a taste, see if you need to season. Wow, that's good. I'm gonna put the mixture into a Ziploc bag. We're gonna take some scissors, cut the tip off, make sure you can find it. Just start in the center, push down, and then come up, just like that. We're gonna finish decorating these. Paprika, sprinkle on the top. These look spectacular. I am first to pick one out. I'm gonna go for that one right there. Y'all need to make these. Today I'm gonna show you how to make fried dill pickles. We're not just doing dill pickles today. I'm gonna be trying bread and butter pickles also. On a regular plate, I'm just gonna line it with some paper towels. And then we're gonna take our pickles and you're gonna lay them in a single layer on the paper towels. This recipe allows for 20 pickles. Take another sheet of paper towels, lay it on the pickles, and then blot them dry. All right, we're gonna set these aside. Now what we're gonna do is make the batter. I use a shallow bowl. We're gonna add 3/4 cup of all-purpose flour, 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder. All of the seasonings are gonna be 1/8 teaspoon. Black pepper, salt, ground cayenne pepper, this is optional, garlic powder. Take a fork and blend this all together. I'm gonna be adding cornmeal, 1/8 cup. Mix that together. We're gonna add 1/2 cup of some club soda. It'll start fizzing. We're gonna mix this all together till we get a nice batter. Okay, look at that batter. The next thing that you wanna have ready, I'm just using another pie plate. I'm just gonna sprinkle in some panko crumbs or you can do bread crumbs. We're gonna place a large deep skillet. We're gonna place it on medium high heat. Add 1 cup of cooking oil and get that nice and hot. We're gonna take our pickles and place 10 of them at a time. So place them right into the batter. Take our fork and we're going to flip these over. We want to make sure they're fully coated. We're going to place them into the panko crumbs and cover them. Right, I'm going to add these two to our hot oil and start frying those up. We want these to get nice and golden brown on the back side. All right, once we get them nice and golden brown on both sides, you can remove them and put them on a paper plate. Look at that. Lined with paper towels to drain. Look at these fried pickles. Serve it up with your favorite appetizer sauce. Of course, we're using ranch. Don't they look crunchy? These are delicious. Got my air fryer out. I'm gonna show you how to make a blooming onion. Grab you a large onion and let's put this one together. Now this is the root side. So we're gonna turn it over to the front of the onion and that's the top right there. Where all of the paper of the onion gather at the top and twist. Come down about 1/2 inch from the top of our onion. We're gonna turn it sideways and we're gonna cut that off. Now it should be able to sit flat. Go in. I'm just gonna cut a little piece right here. You wanna take all that outer layer off. Get all of that off. We're gonna place the cut side of our onion onto our work surface. Take your knife, and we're gonna always be about half an inch below our root end of the onion. Cut into the onion, go all the way down, and then cut through. Where the cut is, we're gonna go right here and do the same thing. And then we're gonna go right here, and we're gonna go two more lines. And then we're gonna cut in between all of those. So we got four already, and then we're gonna make eight by cutting in between the lines. All right, then we're gonna cut those. Should have about 16 slices. When you turn it over, it should just open up. If you just let it sit for about 5 minutes, it'll all start pulling apart. We're gonna go ahead now and start making the batter. So we're going to add some seasonings to 2 cups of all-purpose flour, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, I'm gonna go across, garlic powder, probably 1/4 teaspoon, ground cumin. It'll add a little warmth, oh, flavor. Oh, it smells good. 1/4 teaspoon of that. A little bit of cayenne pepper, a little heat won't hurt. It's optional. We're gonna put some in there. Smoked paprika, y'all load it up. Oh, also give it some color and a little black pepper. Blend this together, just take a whisk and slowly combine it. Make sure the seasonings are where you want them because this is going to be the flavor of your blooming onion. All right, let's set this aside. Let's bring over a medium bowl and we're gonna crack in 3 eggs. There we go. All right, we're gonna pour in 1 cup of milk, 1/2 cup of water. Now I'm gonna throw some seasonings into here, just about 1/4 teaspoon of each. We're gonna whisk this all together. All right, let's get this out of the way. I'm gonna bring a pan over. I'm gonna put my onion in it, get it over here where the flour is. We're gonna take a spoon and we're just gonna shake the flour all over the onion. Dredge it good. Make sure you're going between all of the petals of the onion. We're just gonna turn it upside down, kind of pat off the excess. All right, we're gonna take the onion, carefully put it into the egg mixture. I'm gonna dunk it in right there. Let it sit for a minute. Make sure that we coat the whole onion with the egg. Put it back into our pan with the flour in it. And then we're going to coat it again with the flour. Make sure you go into all the petals. Take some foil. We're gonna take the onion. We're gonna gather it all together. Turn it upside down. Just kind of shake it off. And we're gonna lay it on the foil. Just kind of roll it up like a bowl. Okay, just like that. Now we're gonna take some cooking spray. I like to use the avocado oil because it suits better in the air fryer. It's just spray lightly your onion. We're gonna take the basket out. Then we're gonna place the onion on it, just like that. We're gonna place it into our air fryer. We're gonna hit air fry. We're gonna take it down to 360. Put a timer on for 25 minutes. Hit start. Every 5 minutes, I'm going to open the tray here. I'm gonna give it a little spritz with some cooking spray and then let it keep going until it gets nice and golden brown. Look at my blooming onion. I made a delicious sauce. Find it in katherinesplates.com. Blooming onion sauce. All right, we're gonna pull one of these off. Gonna give it a dip and give it a try. Mmm, love that crunch. That batter was seasoned really well, very delicious. Give me a thumbs up on this one. Make sure you comment down below, and if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below and that bell notification. That way, you'll always know when shows like this one here are posted. I'll see y'all on the next episode.